नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो नमो अभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञानधर प्रत्यकर्तुः ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूम वशिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्य मथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरुं संततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसुख सौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाशरे जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् सो एज यूजुअल देयर सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइस लेट मी फर्दर क्लोज द विंडो So in the Bhashya, I just wanted to make a correction. So there was a Vaidika quotation there, iti Brahmana yajeta. In the Vyakhyana, there were other Vaidika Vakyas given. So naha vai snatva bhikshyeta. So there, naha vai snatva bhikshyeta, I didn't cover that, and also Krishna Kesho. So Krishna Kesho Agnin Adadita, there the Adhikara in Homa, basically Adhikara in the sense, who is a superior Adhikari, in comparison also who is better. In a temple, if you have a Purohita, who is supposed to be better if you have two available, one is better than the other, as per the Vedas, Dharma Shastra, जातपुत्रः सो दि मंत्र हियर जातपुत्रः कृष्णकेशो अग्निनादधीत सो इन पुरोहित एंड इन ऋत्विज आल्सो वन हू हैज अ सन इज बेटर देन अ ब्रह्मचारी और वन हू डज नॉट हैव अ सन इन कंपैरिजन वन हू हैज अ सन हू हैज अ बेटर अधिकार कंपैरेटिवली सुपीरियर देयर ओनली रीजन इज बिकॉज He has a son, meaning the karma will continue, the Vaidika karma will continue, he can hand over it to the next generation also. Therefore, he is, in long-term perspective also, he is better from the temple management also from that perspective. But anyway, Vaidika adhikara, this is an explanation to justify as to why one is better than the other, although both have gone to the same Gurukula. One is married and he is handing over the karma to his putra, so he is extending his family, the Vaidika karma will continue. So thereby, Jata putra Krishna Keshaha. So Jata putraha is a word which is missing here. I just checked the mantra because I was a little doubtful as to what this means. Generally, it is said as that Krishna Keshaha, one who has black hair, but then that person should get married. There also it is used, but then what it means is because of that Jataputra being there. And when a son is born, that time itself his hair should be black. So by Kaimutika Nyaya, during marriage definitely it has to be black. And Nahavai Snatva. So this is the mantra for basically for Grahastha Ashrama. Not the Krishna Kesha, but Nahavai Snatva Bhiksheta. I didn't talk about this. सो नह वही स्नात्वा, स्नात्वा हियर मीनिंग हैविंग टेकन अ बाथ एंड दिस इज अ रिचुअलिस्टिक बाथ विच मीन्स द बाथ प्री मैरिज. सो देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ अ यू गाइज मे बी मोर अवेयर ऑफ दिस. सो वन हु हैज टेकन अ बाथ मीनिंग वन हु हैज गॉटन मैरिड that particular ritualistic bath and then gotten married. So he has entered the grihastashrama. He is no longer a brahmachari. So nahavai na bhiksheta. That kind of a person should not go for bhiksha. The adhikari for adhikarityam for bhiksha is only for a brahmachari and a sannyasi. Turiyashrama. So as soon as one becomes a grihastha, he loses adhikara in bhiksha. He should not live on bhiksha. He should earn and take care of others. In fact, grahastha grihe tishtati. If you look at all the other three ashramas, brahmachari ashrama, there is a char dhatu. So those who know vyakrana, there is a char dhatu, which is gacchartaka. So brahmachari keeps on moving around. Then the third ashrama, vanaprastha, there prastha. Stha means gati nivruttu, but prastha means he is, prasthana means he is going away. So there is also gacchartaka. Gacharta is there. So he also moves around. Vanaprastha moves around. Then he or she. And in Turiya Ashrama Sannyasa, there also Nyasa shows moving around. He also moves around. Sannyasi is not supposed to stay in the same place for more than 3 days. So all the other three ashramas have Gacharta Dhatu. They all show movement. But the second ashrama, grahastha der grihe tishtati iti grahastha, one who stays at home and thereby he is the pillar, he is the central pillar for all the other three ashramas. If that entity takes to bhiksha, then who is the person who will give bhiksha? There is no ashrama left to give bhiksha because all the others, vanaprastha is supposed to be in the vana, there they survive on whatever is there around. But then sannyasi and brahmachari go around for bhiksha. They are supposed to be taken care by the grahastha. So he has no adhikara in bhiksha. So I just wanted to revisit that. Another thing that I wanted to talk about is, yeah, here I didn't complete it. So it may be erroneous because I was talking about pratyak. So while explaining pratyak, pratipurva kanchithatu I mentioned and then I said pratyak is innermost self. But how do you land there? Generally, नैसर्गिक व्यवहार इज वॉट आई एम मनुष्य आई हैव दुख आई हैव सुख माई इंद्रियाज आर स्ट्रांग और वीक सो दिस इज जनरली द केस बट देन प्रत्येक आत्मा इज नॉट दैट आत्मा दैट वी नो अवर सेल्फ एज बीइंग बट वॉट इज द रियल नेचर दैट इज प्रत्येक इनर मोस्ट एंड हाउ डू यू डिराइव दैट सो प्रति वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रति प्रति मीन्स प्रातिलोम्यन सो प्रातिलोम्यन डज नॉट मीन इनर मोस्ट प्रातिलोम्यन मीन्स विरुद्धत्वेन विलक्षणतया सो दैट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड हियर एज विलक्षणतया दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रति उपसर्ग सो प्रातिलोम्येन एज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट दैट इज गिवन इन द अर्लियर पार्ट सो असत जड़ दुख दिस इज कंसिडर्ड एज अवर नेचर विच इज नॉट ट्रू सो देयरफॉर असत जड़ दुखात्मक अहंकारादि विलक्षणतया डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दैट different from ahankaradi which is asat jada or dukkhatmaka and what is the real swarupa asat chit sukhatmaka so as opposed to that so this is the meaning of prati vilakshana to asat jada and dukkha dukkhatmaka meaning sat chit sukhatmaka respectively it is vilakshana sat is vilakshana viruddha to asat chit opposed to jada एंड सुख अपोज टू दुख इत्यादि एंड अंचति अंचति मीनिंग इज प्रकाशते सो प्रति मीनिंग इज विलक्षणतया एंड अंचु धातु दट मीनिंग इज प्रकाश प्रकाशते इति प्रत्यक ओके सो जस्ट टू रीविजिट दैट देन इन द एंड व्हाट वी लुक दैट एवं आत्मनि अनात्म तद्धर्माध्यासम उदाहृत्य अनात्मनि आत्मनो अपि संसृतत्वेन अध्यासमाह तञ्चैत इति देन द ऑपोजिट वे ऑल्सो देर इज अध्यासा सो अध्यासा इज इंटरमिंगलिंग ऑफ द धर्मास बोथ वेज युष्मत् विद अस्मत् एंड अस्मत् विद युष्मत्। अहमिति अध्यासे चितात्मनः भानं वाच्यम् अन्यथा जगदान्ध्यापत्तेः। सो तंच, लेट्स लुक एट व्हाट इज तंच टू रिमाइंड अस। इन द मूल सो तंच प्रत्यगात्मानं सर्वसाक्षिणं तद्विपर्येण अंतःकरणादिषु अध्यस्यति। सो द अंतःकरण धर्माज आर सुपरइम्पोज ऑन आत्मा। दिस इज व्हाट वी सो इन द अर्लियर पार्ट। जी अजर्वी अध्यास इज ऑल्सो ट्रू। तंच प्रत्यगात्मानम, दैट प्रत्यगात्मा ऑन विच देर इज अध्यास ऑफ द अहंकारादि धर्मास विच धर्मी अध्यास प्रिसीडिंग ऑफ कोर्स सर्वसाक्षिणम तद विपर्येण अंतकरणादिषु अध्यस्यति। सो दिस प्रत्यगात्मा इज सर्वसाक्षी, इट इज अ साक्षी, इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विथ एनीथिंग, इट इज असंग। That asanga pratyagatma who is sakshi, who is not involved in any vyavahara, has nothing to do with ahankarid because they are mithya. Sarva sakshinam tadviparyena, opposed to the earlier adhyasa, it is exactly opposite. Tadviparyena antakkaranadishu adhyasyati. So this sarva sakshi who has got the attributes of the अहंकारादि एंड देयर बाय हैज लॉस्ट द साक्षित्वम इटसेल्फ बिकॉज द साक्षी हैज नाउ बिकम संसारी एज दो दिस साक्षी इज कंसिडरिंग वन सेल्फ एज वॉट असत जड़ इत्यादि इन वन वे और द अदर इन सम वेज थिंकिंग दैट एटलीस्ट यू नो आई एम गोइंग टू विदर अवे लाइक अ पॉट लाइक द बॉडी The pot withers away, the body withers away, I am also going to die. I have disease. All these ideas are already superimposed. And then the body is taken to be real, it is taken to be sentient, it is considered to have ananda, leading to ananda, at least indriyas leading to ananda, etc. Therefore, that sarvasakshi now, sakshi, atma dharma, which are satchit, आनंद सचित अनंत और सत्यम ज्ञानम आनंद एंड ऑल दीज सचित आनंद और सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंत बोथ मीन द सेम थिंग दैट आनंद इज सुपर इम्पोज द चैतन्य सुपर इम्पोज एंड द सत्ता इज सुपर इम्पोज ऑन द अहंकारादि प्रपंच सो तद विपरीत अंतकरणादिशु ऑन द अंतकरण एंड एवरीथिंग एक्सटेंडिंग टू द एंटायर प्रपंच विच इज जड़ असत एंड It is jada, asat, asat jada, and it is not that which gives ananda really. So unto those there is an adhyasa of sakshi dharmas, atma dharmas. Vyakhyana. Ahamiti adhyase chidatmano bhanam vachyam. Now, why should this kind of an adhyasa be taken? Why not just consider as there being ahankaradi adhyasa on atma? That is sufficient because I consider myself as a samsari because the deha is undergoing all sorts of trouble. I am associated there. Therefore, one can conclude with all this analysis that ahankaradi dharma, sharira dharmas are superimposed on myself. I consider myself as sukhi dukhi. Sukhi Dukhi, I consider myself as traveling to Swarga Ityadi, whereby I do all these prescribed karmas or kamya karmas. Thereby the ahankaradi dharmas are taken as my dharma. I consider myself as ahankaradi deha ityadi, brahmana, kshatriya ityadi. Why should you talk about the adhyasa other way around? Why not just leave the other adhyasa and live on with this adhyasa and consider this adhyasa and talk about that alone, how that adhyasa should be taken away? No, it won't work. Why ahamiti adhyase? When this ahankara is superimposed on oneself, aham aham, when you have that pratiti, in that adhyasa also, aham is an adhyasa, aham manushya, it is an adhyasa. This deha ahankara adi, which is there, that appears to be sentient. None of those have their own satta, none of those have their own chitta, but the prapancha is visible to be there, is heard to be there, is tasted to be there. So chaitanya vyavahara is there. You see a human being, a prani living on, prani, pakshi, all these. None of these will be known unless there is chaitanya backing. So there should be the other way adhyasa also. Satta and chitta should be there. Bhana won't be there. Even if you say, let's say that it is there, the prapancha is there. How do you know it is there? The chaitanya should reveal the prapancha. And how will it reveal unless there is adhyasa the other way around also? Unless the light reflects, sunlight reflects off the object, you cannot see the object. The pot does not have its own light, otherwise it would shine in the dark. How do you see the pot? The ghata pratiti takes place only when the sunlight bounces off it. Similarly, chaitanya should somehow appear there in the ghata for ghata bhana to take place. Otherwise, ghata won't reveal itself. It does not reveal itself, but it appears as though the ghata is there, it reveals itself, ghata bhana is there. We don't say the ghata is shining in my mind. It is shining outside. Why is it shining outside? Shining not literally. Shining is the meaning of chaitanya, bhana. So how does the vritti vyapti and phala vyapti take place? Chaitanya has some association there. Satta and spurti is outside. It is not within. The ghata appears to be there. And bhana is there, therefore asti bhati, aham iti adhyase. So when I know I, there all the more so. When it is true about ghata itself, then what to talk about ahankara? When ahankara comes up, this aham bhana won't take place. Let the ahankara be there, it would be revealed as what? Yet I have something called as ahankara. It won't appear as aham, as I it won't appear. Ahamkara is a name given to the antakkarana only when it is seen as I. Not mamatvena, ahamtvena. When I consider the antakkarana as I, then alone it shines forth as ahamkara. Then a name is given as ahamkara. Ahamkara meaning itself is that. Ahamkriti ahamkara. Bhave vitpati. There is bhava there, aham bhava is there. That aham bhava shows there is aham bhana. That won't take place. Further what? The entire prapancha won't be revealed to this aham, who himself has satta and spurti adhyasa. Therefore, aham ity adhyase chidatmanaha bhanam vachyam. This chidrupatma should have bhana in that ahankara, in that ahankara the prapancha also entirely. So in yushmat pratyaya also there should be asmat pratyaya, asmat dharma adhyasa in yushmat. Therefore you will have yushmat pratyaya. So aham iti adhyase chidatmano bhanam vachyam anyatha jagadandhyapatye. Otherwise nothing in the prapancha can be known. Nacha anadhyastasya adhyase bhanam asti. And that which is not adhyasta, not superimposed on the chaitanya, tasya bhanam nasti. Other way also true. So adhyasa, we have taken the earlier way as the ahankaradi on Atma. Then the ahankaradi should also have ahamadhyasa because of satta and spurti. Only spurti is mentioned here. Otherwise there would be jagadandya prasanga. But it should also be understood that without the adhyasa, if it is not adhyasa, then there won't be bhana. Chaitanya the chidbhana, that I is a Chaitanya, is a Chidbhana. Unless it is Adhyastha, there can't be Bhana. So, Nacha Anadhyastasya Adhyase Bhanam Asti. In the Adhyasa case, unless something is superimposed, there won't be the Bhana of that. So, in that, whenever you say there is Adhyasa, this Ahankara is an Adhyasa, and you that is established by the other way also. But in that Ahankara Adhyasa itself, Chaitanya Bhana won't take place, unless Chaitanya is Adhyastha. So, Ahamiti Adhyase, what is Ahamiti Adhyasa? This has already been taken care of by the earlier process. The Aham is an Adhyasa in Chidatma. But this in this Adhyasa, Chaitanya Bhana is there. Meaning in the Aham, Ahankara, there is Chaitanya Bhana. That won't take place. That is mentioned here as Nacha Anadhyastasya Chaitanyasya. Chitaha Nacha Anadhyastasya Kasyapi Adhyase Bhanamasti. In the case of Aham, there is a Chaitanya Bhana. That won't take place. And Jagadandya Prasanga, Jagadandya Apattihi, that means Jagadandha, nothing in the prapancha, the entire prapancha, not even a single bit of prapancha would be known. Why? Because Chaitanya isn't there. Unless you have Chaitanya reflecting off there, you won't know that it is there. So you cannot say, oh, Jagat, this Ahankaradi prapancha does not have Chaitanya Adhyasa. Oh, then it cannot be known. If it is known, then the Chaitanya Adhyasa is there. Tasmat Rajatadau idam iva atmanaha samsarga adhyasa ishtavyaha. So both ways, there has to be adhyasa. And the example given is the pratibhasika stala. Tasmat Rajatadau idam iva. That's the example. Just like in the Rajata, Shukti Rajata, this silver which is not existent but appears to be. Why does it appear to be? Because the idamamsha of the adhisthana shukti, that is adhyastha in rajata. What kind of adhyasa is that? Idam is really there. So there is no swarupa adhyasa. But there is samsarga adhyasa. There is a sambandha of idam with rajata. That is why you say idam rajatam. The idam rajatam bhana, that won't take place unless the idam of the adhisthana is also superimposed on the rajata. Not only rajata superimposed on shuktika idam, idamamsha, but the idamamsha is also superimposed. And we have seen that the shuktika has adhyasa of rajata by swarupa also, because rajata is not really existent. So swarupa adhyasa is also there. Sarupena nasti, rajatam nasti, tarhi pratiyate iti kritva sarupadhyasa upi. So there is a sarupadhyasa. Samsarga adhyasa anyway is there is a samsarga sambandha with the rajata, of the rajata with the idam amsha of the shuktika. Other way around, there is no sarupadhyasa because idam amsha of the shukti is there. Shukti is really existent, really in the sense yavaharika. But the samsarga is adhyastha. There is no samsarga. Why? Because there is no sambandha possible with something which is non-existent. Meaning, rajata is not really existent. At vyavaharika level, rajata is not there. But still, sambandha has to be accepted. What kind of sambandha? It is, the sambandha samsarga is tadatmena, but what kind of samsarga? It is adhyastha. So, samsarga adhyasa ishtavya. Tadviparyena iti. Then further what? Tadviparyena, has already we have seen that, as opposed to what was there in the earlier case. So tasya adhyastasya jadasya viparyayaha adhishtanattvam. So what is viparyaya? Viparyayena. Opposed to the earlier case. Contrasted to the earlier case of ahankaradi adhyasa on atma. Compared to that, this is Viparya. What is Viparya? Tasya adhyastasya. Adhyastha is jada. Jada was adhyastha in atma earlier. Ahankaradi jada. सो अध्यस्तस्य जडस्य विपर्ययेण विपर्ययेण विपर्यय इज व्हाट विपर्यय मींस अधिष्ठानत्वम् जड़ा रजता इन दी रजता केस अर्लियर सी तस्माद् रजतादौ इदम् इव आत्मनः संसर्गाद्यासे एष्टव्य सो एग्जांपलिफाइड आई डिडंट कवर सो इन दी आत्मा केस आल्सो आत्मा इज अधिष्ठान जस्ट लाइक इदम् अंश इदम् इन दी शुक्तिका इज अधिष्ठान सिमिलरली आत्मा इज अधिष्ठान दिस आत्मा स्वरूपेण अस्ति आत्मा इज डेफिनेटली देर देर फोर देर इज नो स्वरूपाध्यास ऑन दी अहंकारादि प्रपंच बट देर इज अ संसर्गाध्यास इष्टव्य दिस इष्ट अदरवाइज यू कैनॉट हैव एनी जगत भान अदर वे राउंड देर इज स्वरूपाध्यास एज वेल एज संसर्गाध्यास विच इज ऑलरेडी बीन कवर्ड नाउ देर तस्य अध्यस्तस्य जडस्य इन दी एग्जाम्प्लीफाइड आत्मा इज अजड़ा चैतन्य वेर एज दी अध्यस्त अहंकारादि प्रपंच इज जड़ा सो तस्य जड़स्य विपर्यय इज अधिष्ठानत्वम् अधिष्ठानत्वम् कुत्र आत्मनि सो चैतन्य एंड दैट चैतन्य चैतन्यम च तदात्मना स्थितम् इति यावत् सो विपर्ययेण मीन्स व्हाट चैतन्यम दैट अधिष्ठानत्वम् विच इज देर इन आत्मा दैट चैतन्य आत्मा चैतन्य रूप आत्मा तदात्मना स्थितम तदात्मना मीन्स दिस तत् इज व्हाट इज मेंशन्ड एज तस्य अध्यस्तस्य अध्यस्त जडात्मना स्थितम इत्यर्थः सो तदात्मना मीन्स चैतन्य इटसेल्फ अपीयर्स टू बी इन दी फॉर्म ऑफ द जड़ प्रपंच द जड़ प्रपंच इज नो लॉन्गर जड़ नाउ इट इज ऑल अहंकार कम्स अलाइव एज दो सो तदात्मना स्थितम् इति यावत् तत्र अज्ञाने केवलात्मना संसर्गः मनसि अज्ञान उपहितस्य देहादौ मन उपहितस्य इति विशेषः सो यू हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर व्हेन यू लुक एट अज्ञान कारण शरीर मनः विच इज सूक्ष्म शरीर एंड देन देह विच इज स्थूल शरीर सो देयर इज शरीरत्रय इन शरीरत्रय देयर इज adhyasa all over all the three shariras there is adhyasa so ajnana is the karana sharira avidya or ajnana is the karana sharira tatra ajnane kevala atmana samsarga what is the samsarga adhyasa there kevala atmana the samsarga is atma alone atma associates with ajnana then manasi ajnana upahitasya संसर्ग संसर्ग हैज एन अनुवृत्ति हियर देन देयर इज अ संसर्ग अध्यास इन द मन आल्सो हाउ इज द एसोसिएशन विद द मनस नॉट ऑफ आत्मा डायरेक्टली द आत्मा विच इज ऑलरेडी एसोसिएटेड विद अज्ञान कारण शरीर दैट हैज संसर्ग विद मनस सो अज्ञान इज ऑलरेडी एन उपाधि फॉर आत्मा व्हेन दैट कॉन्ग्लोमरेट दैट एंटिटी which is already taken ajnana as an upadhi that chaitanya atma which has already taken ajnana as its upadhi that entity is associated with manah so manasi ajnana upahitasya samsargah unto the antakarana the ajnana upahita atma has association Then this additional granthi which is formed with the antakarana now. So there is an avidya granthi, there is an antakarana with which there is a samsarga and now this with another layer is an avidya layer, then the antakarana layer, this entity has grown fat now, becomes fatter by taking deha also as upadhi. So manas has already become an upadhi over and above ajnana being an upadhi, then deha adau. Unto Deha and then Adipadena Putra Ityadi, what we saw earlier, Gauna Atmani. So Deha do Mana Upahitasya iti Samsarga iti Visheshaha. So the difference between the three is what is that which associates? Earlier, Atma alone associates with Ajnana, then Atma plus Ajnana associates with Manas, and then Atma plus अज्ञान प्लस मनस एसोसिएट्स विद देहा, सो देहा दो मन उपहितस्य, माइंड हैज ऑलरेडी बिकम उपाधि, अंतकरण हैज ऑलरेडी बिकम उपाधि, उपहितस्य संसर्ग इति विशेष। एवं आत्मनि बुद्ध्याद्यध्यासत् अध्यासात् कर्तृत्वादि लाभः, बुद्ध्यादौ च आत्माध्यासात् चैतन्य लाभ इति भाव। सो एवं आत्मनि बुद्ध्याद्यासात्, सो अंतकरण मन बुद्धि इत्यादि, सो बुद्धि एंड मन हियर बोथ आर उपलक्षण फॉर दी अदर्स ऑल्सो, इट मीन्स अंतकरण। सो एवं आत्मनि बुद्ध्याद्यध्यासात्, व्हेन दी सती सप्तमी, एवं आत्मनि बुद्ध्याद्यासात्, तो सॉरी नॉट सती सप्तमी, विशेष सप्तमी। सो अंटू दी आत्मा व्हेन देर इज बुद्ध्यादि अध्यासा, देन हेतु पंचमी, देर बाय व्हाट कर्तृत्वादि लाभः। वन, द आत्मा कैन बिकम कर्ता भोक्ता ओनली व्हेन देर इज अध्यासा ऑफ बुद्धि, मीनिंग अंतकरण, अंटू आत्मा देर इज अ संसर्ग, संसर्ग अध्यासा। So what do you get by adhyasa, taking adhyasa as granted? When you accept adhyasa of ahankaradi onto atma, then one becomes a karta bhokta. This is the understanding. You are not really a karta bhokta. Due to adhyasa of the ahankaradi antakkarana onto yourself, you are taking the anya dharma is your own dharma. Therefore, आत्मा विच इज अकर्ता भोक्ता एज दो बिकम्स अ कर्ता भोक्ता। सो दैट इज द बेनिफिट ऑफ कंसिडरिंग अध्यासा वन वे। अदर वे वाई डू कंसिडर अध्यासा, बुद्ध्यादौ च आत्माध्यासा चैतन्य लाभ इति भावः, द बुद्ध्यादि अपीयर्स टू बी चैतन्य, द बुद्धि एज दो कम्स अलाइव, अंतकरण कम्स अलाइव, आई एम अ थिंकर, आई एम एग्जिस्टेंट एज वॉट, this kind of a human being, deha. So you say, oh, this man exists, this woman exists, he's a sentient being. How do you get that? Only because of atma adhyasa, chaitanya roopa atma adhyasa. So chaitanya roopa atma adhyasa buddhyado chaitanya labha, kasya chaitanyam buddhyadehe chaitanyam, buddhyadi dehadi all appears to be चैतन्य, नॉट देहादि, बुद्धियादि मीन्स देह, अंतकरण, देह, बुद्धि, ऑल दीज अपीयर टू बी अलाइव, द वृत्ति सीम्स अलाइव, ज्ञान रूप, सो वी से दैट इट इज वृत्ति, व्हाट वृत्त्यात्मक ज्ञानम, ज्ञान इज चैतन्य, हाउ डज द वृत्ति गेट द चैतन्य, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस आत्माध्यास ऑन टू इट। सो अदर वे अध्यास हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड, अदरवाइज यू कांट गेट चैतन्य। सो चैतन्य लाभ यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दी अदर वे अध्यास ऑल्सो। वर्णित अध्यास उपसंहरति एवम् अयम् इति, दिस एंटायर अध्यास इज कंक्लूडेड बाय भगवान भाष्यकार, व्हाट डज ही से, एवम् निमूल, एवम् अयम् अनादिर अनंतो नैसर्गिको अध्यासो मिथ्या प्रत्यय रूप कर्तृत्व कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व प्रवर्तक सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्ष। ही सेज दिस अध्यास इज सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्ष, सर्वेषां लोकानां प्रत्यक्ष, फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वन इट इज प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध, अनुमान हैज बीन गिवन, अर्थापत्ति हैज बीन गिवन, शास्त्र प्रमाण हैज बीन गिवन, बट ऑल दिस इज नॉट नीडेड। Why? Because it is pratyaksha to each and every human being. Each and every person knows that there is adhyasa. How? Evam. What has been explained? The adhyasa in this manner, what all has been explained? That is only to establish something which is already known to others. That's why Bhagavan Bhashyakara started with pratyaksha. Aham manushya, is it pratyaksha? Aham karta, bhokta, is it pratyaksha? Then it is adhyasa. Why? Because Swarupena you are not Karta Bhukta Ityadi, you are not Manushya, you are not man or a woman, not a Brahmana, not a Kshatriya Ityadi. So Evam Ayam Anadihi Anantaha Naisargika Adhyasa. This Adhyasa is, which is Sarvaloka Pratyaksha, is Naisargika. It is but natural. मीनिंग इट इज देयर सिंस बर्थ, इट हैज बीन देयर फॉर एवर, सो दैट नैसर्गिक हाउ नैसर्गिक अनादि अनंत इट इज अनादि दिस अध्यासा हैज बीन देयर फॉर एवर अनादि हाउ कैन इट बी अनंत इज देयर एनी होप एट ऑल देन इफ अध्यासा इज अनंत देयर वोंट बी मोक्ष सो निर्मोक्ष प्रसंग दैट्स नॉट द मीनिंग अनंत मीन्स वॉट फॉर सर्वलोक जनरली एज एन उत्सर्ग जनरल रूल वॉट इट विल नॉट गो ऑन इट्स ओन इट विल नेवर गो इट विल ऑलवेज बी देयर देयर फॉर अनंत ओनली इन द ज्ञान अवस्था इट विल गो सो ज्ञानम विना न गच्छति इति अनंत देयर फॉर इट इज सेड एज अंतो नास्ति ज्ञानम विना अंत अध्यासस्य अंत नास्ति देयर फॉर अनंत Further what then is it real? No, it goes away by jnana. It appears to be there, all this chaitanyatvam satta chitta appears to be in the prapancha as though it is separately existent. But it is not. So it is what? Mithya pratyaya rupa. Mithya is maya. Meaning, magically appears, it is false, it is, has no real existence. So mithya pratyaya rupa, adhyasa itself is mithya. कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व प्रवर्तक फर्दर वॉट इट मेक्स अ पर्सन अ कर्ता भोक्ता वन गेन्स कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अध्यास एंड इट इज सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्ष व्याख्यान अनादि अविद्यात्मकतया कार्याध्यास अनादित्व अध्यासात् संस्कार तथा अध्यास इति सो व्हाट इज अनादि Adhyasa is anadi. What is the meaning of anadi? It has already been explained. So this is what? Upasamvarti. It is a conclusion. What has already been given is summarized. And what was the explanation given for anadi? Anadi is what? Avidyatmakataya. Adhyasa is what? Avidya karya. Therefore, avidyatmaka. Avidya is its very swarupa. Adhyasa being avidya karya, it is avidya. Just like ghata being mrit karya, it is mrit. So if you tap on a clay pot and inquire what is this, so it is clay. So clay pot is also clay, it is nothing but clay. Similarly, anadi avidyatmaka taya adhyasa is what? It is avidyatmaka, it is karana avidya. Karyadhyasasya, so this adhyasa which is karyadhyasa, anadityam. Because avidya is anadi, its karya is called as anadi. Otherwise what? Really, it is not anadi literally. Why is it called as anadi? Because it is continuing since ever. Which we have seen as what? Adhyasat samskaraha tataha samskarat adhyasaha. So it's like a seed and sapling, seed and tree. So from adhyasa, which is karyadhyasa, comes out of avidya. From this adhyasa, samskara is left. And in the next janma, we will take it as next janma. Then we can extend it to each and every case of adhyasa within. Because there is an assumption that I am a manushya, I'll be manushya this entire life. In next janma, there will be samskara. Because one considers oneself to be whatever kind of antakkarana it is, configured for whichever kind of deha, one considers oneself as that kind of a prani. That adhyasa will leave a samskara, and that samskara, from that samskara, there will be later adhyasa in the next janma. So, samskara, tataha is tasmat samskara adhyasa. So, adhyasa leaves a samskara, samskara brings about adhyasa. That adhyasa will leave another samskara. That another samskara will bring about yet another adhyasa. And this is true, within the janma also. Every moment we have adhyasa, the prior adhyasa has left the samskara due to which we have adhyasa. Pravahataha naisargikattvam. So naisargikaha adhyasa. In the Mula, Naisargika has been explained. What, why? What is this Naisargikattvam? pravahata. It has been there forever. So there is a samskara and adhyasa pravaha. There is a flow, a chain of events. Thereby, naisargikattvam, it is naturally going on. So, evam upadanam nimittam cha uktam bhavati. So, what is the upadana? Avidya is upadana. So, avidya is included by, so naisargikattvam, anadi ananta, there is a mention there. So, evam upadanam, upadana is ajnana, nimitta is samskara. Why does adhyasa come up again? What is the nimitta? The nimitta is samskara is there. So what was the karana, upadana karana? Upadana karana is ajnana. Is ajnana there? Oh, then you have material available. Then what is the nimitta? Just because material is there, there is not a karya always. Always there won't be a karya. Just because clay is there, you won't have ghata. So then nimitta is there, kulala is there. He picks up the clay and shapes it up into a pot. Similarly, what is the nimitta here? Just because avidya is there, will the adhyasa come about? No. Samskara is there. So samskara becomes the nimitta for the adhyasa to take place. Evam upadanam nimittam cha uktam bhavati. Jnanam vina dhvamsabhavad anantyam. Since there won't be adhyasa, dhvamsa, vidvamsa, nasha, without jnana, therefore, anantyam, the adhyasa is ananta, unless there is jnana. Therefore, since jnana is an exception, meaning everyone is continuing in ajnana, nobody is looking for jnana really, not many are looking for it, therefore, what adhyasa is going to be ananta. One who wants to step out will gain jnana and step out, therefore, for that person, there will be anta of adhyasa. Otherwise, anantyam of adhyasa. Taduktam Bhagavad Gita su. So, Bhagavad Gita su, Bhagavan Krishna says, Narupamasyeha tathopalabhyate nanto na chadir na cha sampratishtha iti. So, in the 15th chapter, he says, so this samsara vruksha, there the description is given of the samsara vruksha. Na rupamasya iha tatha upalabhyate, na antaha na cha adihi, na cha sampratishtaiti. So it has been mentioned there also by Bhagavan Krishna as to this adhyasa, the samsara vruksha is adhyasa. Vruksha is a simile. So, Purushottama Yoga, in that chapter, this samsaruksha adhyasa does not have adi, anta, ityadi, nacha adi, nantaha, and na rupamasya iha tatha upalabhyate. The way it is not known. Nacha sampratishta, it has no real existence. It appears to be there. So, mithyatvam is also mentioned, anadityam is also mentioned, and anantatvam is also mentioned. But jnanam vina na gacchati, that is the anantyam. Hetu muktva swarupamaha. Okay, adhyasa hetu is known as to what? Adhyasa hetu is ajnana as upadana and samskara as nimitta. What is it swarupa? What is this adhyasa? Mithya pratyerupaha. So, mithya means anirvachaniya, pratyaha, yasya adhyasasya, sa adhyasa, mithya pratyaha. Pratya, rupam, yasya. So, that rupa is what? That pratyaya, pratyate, that pratyaya is what? Pratyate iti, prapancha, artha adhyasa. So, that is explained here. Mithya, maya. Mithya meaning is maya. Taya pratiyate, mayaya pratiyate iti, mithyaya mayaya pratiyate iti, pratyaya. Pratiyate iti pratyaya means what? Karmani vitpatti. So, kare prapancha, arthadhyasa. So, what is this adhyasa? Adhyasa is arthadhyasa, which is mithya. Mithya, mayaya pratiyate. Due to maya, there is a pratiti. If you say there is a pratiti pratyaya, then that will be jnana adhyasa. बट प्रतीयते इट अपीयर्स व्हाट अपीयर्स दिस एंटायर प्रपंच कार्य प्रपंच अपीयर्स ड्यू टू माया देयरफॉर इट इज व्हाट मिथ्या प्रत्यय रूप तत्प्रतीतिश्च इति एवं स्वरूप इत्यर्थः सो कार्य प्रपंच इज व्हाट प्रतीयते इति प्रत्यय देन तत्प्रतीति इज कार्य प्रपंचस्य प्रतीति माया प्रतीयते माया च प्रतीति माया यस्य कार्य प्रपंचस्य प्रतीति सह कार्य प्रपंच प्रतीयते सो दैट कार्य प्रपंच यह कार्य और अदर वे राउंड यह कार्य प्रपंच प्रतीयते यह प्रपंच प्रतीयते इति प्रत्यय एंड ऑल्सो व्हाट प्रतीति प्रत्यय प्रतीति प्रत्यय विल टेल यू कार्य प्रपंच प्रतीति इज देयर यू हैव कॉग्निशन ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड एंड व्हाट इज दिस वर्ल्ड अपीयर्स ड्यू टू माया दैट विच अपीयर्स ड्यू टू माया इज अर्थाध्यास एंड द अपीयरेंस ऑफ दैट which appears due to maya which is also due to maya me appearance is also due to maya what is that that is jnana adhyasa so what is the swarupa mithya pratyaya rupah appears due to maya and the meaning exists due to maya so called existence is due to maya and also what appearance is also due to maya both artha is an adhyasa and pratiti meaning jnana is also an adhyasa evam swarupah ityartha evam swarupam yasya adhyasasya sa adhyasa evam swarupah bauri it is that kind of an adhyasa what is the swarupa of the adhyasa is that which has this kind of a swarupa what kind of swarupa appears due to maya comes up due to maya and the appearance is also due to maya it is anirvachaniya that's what it means anirvachaniya तस्य कार्यमह एंड व्हाट इज द एंड रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस अर्थाध्यास एंड ज्ञानाध्यास व्हाट हैपेंस ड्यू टू दिस अध्यास कर्तृत्वेति व्हाट हैज बीन सेड कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व प्रवर्तकः दिस अध्यास बिकम्स वन दैट प्रॉड्स इंस्टिगेटर इंस्टिगेट्स व्हाट इंस्टिगेट्स डूअरशिप एंड एक्सपीरियंसरशिप सो कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व आई एम अ कर्ता फॉर दिस भोगा देयरफॉर आई एम अ भोक्ता ऑल्सो दिस काइंड ऑफ Prodding is done by this adhyasa. Pramanam nigamayati. What is the pramana for that? He says, I don't need to give you any pramana. I have given this. All your nanu nachas have been answered. Nachavachyam, nanu. All this you have said, you know, pratyaksha. Let it be pratyaksha, but show me what other pramana is there. I have given you arthapatti pramana. I have given you anumana pramana. I have given you shabda pramana. So शब्द प्रमाण also has been, श्रुति प्रमाण has also been, but what is the real प्रमाण now? In conclusion, प्रमाणम निगमयति, what is the conclusive प्रमाण really? सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्षः. They may not know that there is an adhyasa, but now after all this discussion, evam, what is adhyasa we have discussed? Does the prapancha appear? Does it go away in? In moksha as in go away in the sense it does not remain a trap anymore meaning there is no samsarittvam for this person anymore who is a jnani therefore it is not real thereby what it is mithya satchet na asachet na pratiyet satchet na badhyet but there is a badha In jnana, there is badha of this ajnana ahankara adi prapancha and during the samsara avastha there is a pratiti. Because there is a pratiti, it cannot be unreal. It cannot be asat. And because there is a sublation, negation by jnana, therefore it cannot be called as sat. It is not real. Thereby it is sadasad vilakshana, mithya. अनिर्वचनीय मिथ्या प्रत्यय रूप एंड सिंस दिस कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व इज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट विच इज नॉट योर स्वरूप देयरफॉर इट हैज टू बी अध्यास एंड सिंस वन नोज वन सेल्फ एज अ संसारी मनुष्य देयर बाय प्रमाणम निगमयति सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्षः सर्वेति नॉट सर्वलोक प्रत्यक्षः दैट इज द प्रमाण प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण इज द रियल प्रमाण इट इज नॉट अर्थापत्ति अनुमान ऑल दीज हैव बेसिस इन प्रत्यक्ष ऑफ कोर्स श्रुति इज अ प्रमाण बट यू डोंट नीड इट वॉट इज प्रत्यक्ष टू यू फॉर दैट श्रुति नीड नॉट कम एंड टेल यू सो इन द एंड वॉट इज द प्रमाण प्रत्यक्ष इज द प्रमाण You know yourself as a manushya. Shruti need not tell you that you are a manushya. That is an adhyasa has been discussed. Once the adhyasa swarupa has been discussed, then what is the pramana? Pratyaksha is the pramana. Do you think yourself as a karta bhukta? Then it is an adhyasa. Do you think you are a brahmana? Adhyasa. Do you think you are a purusha? Adhyasa. Stri, adhyasa. Putra, pita, mata, adhyasa. Bandhu, adhyasa. Anything that you take as pratyaksha to you, that itself is a pramana for adhyasa because adhyasa swarupa has already been discussed which is shown by sambhavana and pramana has been given. So lakshana has been given. What is the lakshana of adhyasa? The discussion at length has gone by. Then the Sambhavana Bhashya showed the possibility of this kind of an adhyasa whose lakshana has already been given. Once the Purvapakshi says, oh, I accept that this kind of a possibility exists, give me pramana. Pramana has also been given. All sorts of pramanas have been given. There is no further discussion possible. Now you go back and say that the real pramana is what we started with pratyaksha because the lakshana was not known then, to which Sambhavana was definitely not there because lakshana itself was not known. Pramana couldn't have been shown because there was no inquiry into it. Now having gone through all of these, let's go back and see what was shown as pratyaksha, manushyoham ityadi. That itself is a pramana for this lakshanika adhyasa. This adhyasa which has a lakshana which has been given. Sakshi pratyaksham eva adhyasa dharmi grahakam manam. So what is a pramana, real pramana? Sakshi reveals that adhyasa. No other pramana is needed. Sakshi pratyaksham. Atma knows. I oneself know that I consider myself as manushya. Therefore, in jnana also, you don't need to go and ask someone else, am I a jnani? You don't need to go and ask your guru. Or, you know, you pray to Ishvara, give me jnana, and then, oh, am I jnani every day? You don't need to do that because this jnana is also pratyaksha. Just like ajnana is pratyaksha, adhyasa is pratyaksha, jnana is also pratyaksha. If there is a doubt whether or not I have jnana, it means that there is no jnana. If there is jnana, there can be no question at all. So, sakshi pratyaksham eva adhyasa dharmi grahakam manam. It is Sakshi pratyaksham itself is pramana, mana is pramana, which helps one understand this, the dharmi and dharma adhyasa both, that itself is pramana, anumana adhikam tu sambhavanartham iti avipretya pratyakshopasamhara krutaha. So what the anumana, arthapatti and shabda pramana which was given, why was it given then? It was given only to establish sambhavana. A possibility. Pramanas were given to establish that possibility, convert that possibility into a nishchaya. Yes, there is an adhyasa. Is there a possibility of this kind of an adhyasa? Anyatra, paratra, paravabhasa, that kind of lakshana of adhyasa was given. Is it possible at all? Yes, it is possible. Once you give it a possibility, then you inquire whether you have it. Yes, it is there. Whether the prani has it, go ityadi, they have it. Then it is established by pratyaksha pramana. Evam adhyasam varnetva tatsadhye vishe prayojane darshayati. So having described this kind of an adhyasa, whose lakshana was given, it is mithya pratyaya rupa ityadi, sakshi pratyaksha, sarvaloka pratyaksha, tatsadhye, sadhye is sadhye darshayati. So it is dvitiya dvivachana. विषय प्रयोजने सो केते साध्ये विषय प्रयोजने तत् साध्य मीन्स अध्यास साध्य व्हाट इज साध्य व्हाट मीन What is that brings about this? That's the vishay prayojane. Once the adhyasa is established, then vishay prayojana is also established, because once adhyasa, once the samsarittvam is adhyastha, then it will go by jnana alone. What jnana? Aikya jnana. So that aikya jnana vishaya becomes a possibility. This is where the adhyasa bhashya opening began, as to in the vyakhyana and the tika. Should there be shastrarambha or not? It shouldn't be there. Why? Because adhikari is not there, vishaya is not there, prayojana is not there, sambandha is not there. Anubandha chatushtaya is lacking. But what is initially missing? Prayojana isn't there. If prayojana is there, then one can think about what vishaya will lead to that prayojana. Prayojana itself is not there. This was the objection. Therefore, in conclusion, having shown adhyasa is there. Why? Because prayojana, why is it not there? Moksha is not possible because bandha is real. Then bandha is shown to be unreal. Why? Bandha is adhyastha. It is an adhyasa. Therefore, on adhyasa siddhi, adhyasam varnayitva, tat sadhye, what is the end resultant? If adhyasa is established, so what? Let there be adhyasa. You can't say so what. Why? Because you objected shastrarambha na karaniya. That na karaniya you cannot say anymore. Why? This shastrarambha you have given into. Therefore, this Brahma Sutra and Sutra Bhashya arambha should be done. Vishaya is there, prayojana. Prayojana is there. What is the prayojana? This adhyasa nivritti itself is prayojana, bandha nivritti. That is moksha. How will it go about? By jnana. So jnana is a vishaya. What jnana? Aikya jnana. Brahmatma aikya jnana will take away this ajnana and its karya, adhyasa. Thereby prayojana and vishaya, both are there. Vishaya prayojane darshayati asyeti mula. अस्य अनर्थ हेतोः प्रहाणाय आत्मैकत्व विद्या प्रतिपत्तये सर्वे वेदांता आरभ्यन्ते. ऑल द वेदांतास हैव द सेम गोल. ऑल द उपनिषद्स हैव द सेम गोल. ऑल द उपनिषद बेस्ड शास्त्रास आल्सो हैव द सेम गोल. व्हाट इज दैट? अनर्थ हेतु प्रहाण, द नाश, द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द अनर्थ हेतु, दैट अविद्या अज्ञान and its adhyasa karya, which is the hetu for anartha, which is the cause for all adversities, bondage, all dukkha. And for purpose of that, sarve vedanta arabhyante, all the vedanta granthas are meant for this very purpose. They begin with the same purpose in mind and go through with the same end goal in mind. What is that? Atmaikatva vidya pratipatte. How does the prahana, the hanana, prakarsha hanana of anartha hetu, avidya, ajnana take place? Takes place by pratipatti. Pratipatti means jnana. Jnana of what? Jnana which is in the form of atmaikatva vidya. It is in the form of atma and brahma ekatvam. Or atma being one alone, meaning brahma alone. So atma ekatva vidya pratipatteye, to reveal that kind of vidya which is oneness of atma with brahma. For that purpose alone all the vedantas are begun. And what is the purpose of that? What is the result of this atma ekatva vidya pratipatti? Atma ekatva vidya prahana of anartha hetu, ajnana and adhyasa. Vyakhyana. So we'll go through, we'll take one more part and maybe do some kind of summary or the just basic of the four sutras without the bhashya ityadi. So I'll just mention this and close. Kartrutvadya anartha hetoho adhyasasya samulasya atyantika nasho mokshaha sa kena ityaha atmeti. So this kartrutvadi anartha hetu, what is the anartha hetu? Kartrutvadi adhyasa. Adhyasa, kartrutva adhyasa, bhoktrutva adhyasa, all this is adhyasa, which is ajnana karya, karya adhyasa. So kartrutvadi anartha hetu, that itself is anartha hetu, that itself is bandha. One considers oneself as a karta, bhoktrutvam will be enforced. One has to take another janma and yet another janma wherever it is, in whichever loka, in whichever sharira, whether a devata or a prani, manushya or a rakshasa, all this will continue, and that is the anartha. The hetu is what? Adhyasa. Kartrutva dhyanartha hetu adhyasasya, which is karyadhyasa due to ajnana as its karana. Samulasya, therefore, ajnana which is its moola. Atyantika nasha moksha. Moksha is what? Atyantika nasha of ajnana and its karyadhyasa. So karyadhyasa, its karya and the karana, ajnana, both should go away. Sa kena, how does it go about? So that is mentioned as atma. Atma, it was mentioned in the moola as what? Atma aikya vidya pratipattaye. We'll see more in the next part. Huh? And we'll close in the next part on Friday. Okay, so, Yamiha Karunikam Sharangatopyari Sahodara Apamahatam Tamahamashu Harim Paramashri Janakajanka Vananta Sukhakurti Tatsat. Namaste.
Namaste, Gandhi. Thank you.